Good morning, everyone. Please rise. Please turn your hymn book to page 48 to 49. Today we will sing the hymn number 23, He. Let's sing first one once. Turn your hymn book to page 5 and refer to item number 5. Today's scripture is taken from Psalms chapter 107, verses 1 and 8. Please listen to God's word. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for men. Psalms chapter 107, verses 1 and 8. Let's read it together. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for men. Psalms chapter 107, verses 1 and 8.
Let's bow and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for your blessings every day. You are the mighty God who always forgives our wrongdoings. Please strengthen our faith so that we know you are the only one who can turn the tides and climb the angry sea. Please give us strength and deliver us from evil. Thank you, Lord, for you're always there when we call. May you bless the whole assembly and the lessons today with your Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Please be seated.
Testing. Good morning, Principal, Vice and Assistant Principals, teachers, and fellow students. I'm Grace from 6C. In the last school year, our school organized certain study tours to let students to have a chance to explore the outside world. The tours organized were different from those in the past as they were subject-based, creating a more diversified and specialized experience in the tours for our students. We're glad to have invited students that joined the tours to share the experience and joy with us today. Now, may we invite our principal and vice and assistant principals to proceed to the auditorium to enjoy the sharing. Now, let's invite the students who joined the Australia Geographical Tour this summer to share their experience with us.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Phoebe from Form 5B.
I'm Tiffany from Form 5C.
I am Agnes from Form 5A.
We went to Western Australia for a study tour in mid-July. We went to Perth and along the north of the Western Australia, which is located near the Indian Ocean. We went to Kings Park in Perth, which is a 4.06 square kilometer park located on the western edge of the Central Business District. There are many native plants, indigenous fungi species, and bird species. Mining was a major source of income of Western Australia in the past, but now they're developing tourism. Unlike Hong Kong, the governments of the Western Australia provide better education to its people. It is hard to find rubbish bins and rubbish on streets, and the seawater is very clean. We think that the Hong Kong government should take Australia as a reference.
In Shark Bay, we had an Aboriginal tour. We ate the fish cooked by the Aboriginal man. The wood used to make the fire is for medicine use. Usually, smoke smelled badly, but the smoke produced from burning the wood was sweet. Also, in Aboriginal culture, they would take the wood from the dead but not the leaf part, as they regard the nature as their family. Can you see the fish here? The Aboriginal man puts the fish directly on the charcoal to cook. And these leaves are the plates. And the fish was so yummy and the experience is so refreshing. And the tour guide also played the Australian Aboriginal traditional musical instruments, the didgeridoo, which can be only played by boys. You can see all our boys here. He also showed us how to do a circular breathing, and his playing was so amazing. And now let's look at a short video.
To sum up, it was a refreshing experience for us. Stunning natural sceneries and the wildlife surrounded us during the whole trip, which amazed all our eyes. Moreover, it was a precious opportunity for us to learn more about the Aboriginal culture because we may not come across this knowledge in our textbook. We were glad that we could try to play the didgeridoo, taste the delicious smoked fish, and looked into the natural medicines from the plants. Moreover, a tour in Perth has also allowed us to experience the life in the city and also discover the big difference of the parks between Hong Kong and Australia. This trip was so awesome, which gave us a fruitful and wonderful lesson. Thank you. May we pass the mic to the next group.
Good morning, everyone. We're group two, and we're going to talk about conservation. And I'm Grace from 6C.
I'm Haley from Form 6C.
I'm Yoyo from Form 6C. So first, we went to a place called Kabari Park. And then there are pedestrian paths which are nicely built in order to minimize the destruction caused by humans.
For Shell Bay, it is made from billions of tiny shells. And it is one of the two only beaches in the world that made entirely from shells.
For Eagle Bluff, there are education boards to tell us the formation of the landform, so to enhance our geographical knowledge.
Also, there are many signal boards to be installed to remind the visitors not to step on the protected area and allow the plants to grow.
For the conservation of wildlife, we went to Yan Chiap National Park and we saw koalas and kangaroos everywhere. There are donation boxes to encourage visitors to give a hand, and the money will be as a financial support to do more protection.
We also went to Monkey Mire. We enjoyed the dolphin experience, and some of our tourmates are luckily selected to feed the dolphins.
For Ningaloo Reef, we had a ride on a glass boat, and we can see the ocean is really well protected, and the water is extremely clear. So the people there have rich marine life knowledge, so we can understand the importance of protecting the ocean.
In Green of Wildlife Park, we can feed the animals by ourselves. Apart from tourists, we can also see many local families there. This can raise our awareness towards protecting the wildlife.
So for the reflection part, Well, Henry Miller has once said, one's destination is never a place, but a new way of seeing things. Well, in Australia, we really develop a new way of seeing things. Why? Because in Hong Kong, we seldom pay much attention about our surroundings, like the trees, the squirrels, like, I don't know, the birds. And in Australia, we paid special attention to our surroundings, even we are on a trip like to 4 or 5 hours on a coach. Why? Because there are actually a lot of wildlife on the way, like porcupines, ostrich, and kangaroos, which are really cute, and we were really excited about them, and a bunch of us actually rushed down and took a lot of photos of them. And besides that, we also have a lot of unforgettable experiences, like we try to feed the dolphins, just as what they have mentioned, and also we try to play a night game in a campsite, which someone have to hold the torch and find out who is not hiding properly. And then we have learned a lot in this tour, and we enjoyed it. So this is the end of our presentation, and I'm going to pass the mic to the next group. Thank you.
Hello everyone, now it's our turn to share a few about the river and coastal landforms that we saw during the trip to Australia. I'm Leo from 5E.
I'm Michael from 5E.
Well, firstly, for the river that we visited the Murchison River on the second day of our tour. The Murchison River is the second longest river in Australia with the length of 820 kilometers and covers an area of about 82,000 square kilometers. And along the river banks, we saw a lot of rocks with various various shapes and sizes, which you can see on the photo in the middle, while also some reef features which can be found in normal rivers, such as the meanders, which means the bends of the rivers can also be found at this river. Well, for the coastal landforms, on the second day of our trip, we visit the Natural Bridge. The Natural Bridge is a landform features an enormous sea arc, which you can saw on the photo on the left, pointed with an arrow, and it simply looks like a bridge. And for the formation of it, it is formed by strong wave erosion, which means that the waves strikes the rocks for millions of years and erode the rocks away, and the headland is being cut through to form a bridge-like arc. And you can see a simple form of the arc on the left-hand side. Yeah, the photo. And it can show you what is the sea arc look like, and it looks like a bridge. Well, on the fourth day of our trip, we visit the Shell Bridge, which have been mentioned before, and it is a bridge in Shark Bay region, and simply a bridge formed by countless shells. And while these photos, you can see how the Shell Bridge is formed as the incoming waves, which is called incoming swash, will deposit all the sediments in the waves, and which is the bridge on the land, and it formed the Shell Bridge.
So now it's my section to talk about the Little Lagoon in day four. So firstly, Little Lagoon is located in the Monkey Mire in the Rock of Denham, and is quite far away from Perth. What about its formation? Firstly, Little Lagoon is formed by a bar, which is formed as a spit grows across a bay, joining up two headlands. It's just like a lake. Yes, I have tell you before, it's quite far from Perth. It's about 8 hours driving from Perth, and it's quite shallow and ideal for swimming. You can see that guy in the water. He is our student. So, in the same day, we also go to the Eagle Bluff. It's also quite far from Perth, like 10.5 hours from Perth, and is particularly a high cliff, and dolphins, sharks, and dugongs may be seen also. So you can see in the photos that dark dots are some creatures like tortoise. And the formation of Eagle Bluff is that landforms formed by strong wave erosion for thousands of years, and a high steep land, but it's not as vertical as a cliff. But up in the high cliff is spectacular, the view. Also, we need to thank our teachers who led us to the trip, and the tour guide, it's a cool guy. And yes, thank you. May we pass the mic to the next session, please.
Thanks.
So we are group 4 and we are going to talk about the pinnacles. I'm Ken from 6B.
I'm Jason from 6C.
I'm Louis from 6C.
So Jason, can you tell us more about the Pinnacles Desert?
The Pinnacle is a desert located in the Lamban National Park. There are many limestone pillars located on it. Ken, do you know how are the limestone pillars formed?
Yes. So the limestone pillars are after many years of different geological processes. After that, the southwesterly carried quartz and sand and eroded them, and so the hardest limestone columns remained and the pinnacles was exposed. So Lewis, can you tell us more about the location of the pinnacles?
Oh, sure, Ken. The Pinnacle Desert is located next to the Indian Ocean. Generally, there should not be a desert next to an ocean because of the supply of moisture from the sea. However, the Pinnacle Desert is located at a subtropical high pressure belt, which the sinking air does not favor the formation of cloud and rain. Also, the continuous offshore wind blowing from the inland of Australia towards the western coast also brings these two amount of moisture, which also form the dry climate in there. Jason, what have you learned from this trip?
I learned that we should appreciate the beauty of nature, like the clear water and the different kinds of wildlife. Besides, I have learned the Aboriginal culture, like playing the didgeridoo as shown in the photo. Also, I learned how to coexist with the nature, like the medical uses for some plants and the sustainable developments of the countries. I think everyone has the responsibility to conserve the natural environment.
So after this tour, we've definitely learned a lot of things about geography, and it was a very fruitful tour, and we've definitely got a lot of memorable memories. And so we would like to thank Mr. Kwan and Ms. Wong to share their invaluable time with us during the vacation. And also, we would like to thank our tour guide, Mr. Craig and YY, for keeping us safe and showing us around. So this is the end of our presentation, and we hope that you will enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. We are from the Symphonic Band. I'm Sophia.
I'm Hikas. Today, we are going to share about our unique experience in Singapore from the 26th to the 31st of July.
I think even if I don't introduce you, you know where it is. Yeah. You know, taking group photos in the airport is like a kind of designated actions.
After our arrival, went to the Yeung Siew Toh Conservatory of Music in the National University of Singapore to have a rehearsal. That room was so big and well equipped that we were all amazed by it.
Sounds so amazing. How good is the equipment?
Firstly, the acoustic effects of the rehearsal room is very nice. The sound we produce is similar to that in the concert hall, which really helped us for rehearsaling for our competition. Also, the music instruments are superb. For example, there is a full set of percussion instruments and three grand piano in the rehearsal room.
Maybe you're wondering that's why we need to have rehearsals. Let me tell you, the next day we joined a competition, namely the Singapore International Band Festival. And it has an 8-year history with competitors from schools in the Southeast Asia region. This year, we've been competing with 60 schools. And guess what results we've got?
We got the silver award. Next time, we are aiming for gold. Therefore, we joined a masterclass after that, so as to improve our standard and capability. The master from Japan taught us a lot about the pieces we have been playing, and we are paying full attention to it, so we can avoid the same mistake next time and perform better.
The next day, we've been to St. Margaret's Secondary School to join a band exchange program. We had great fun, didn't we?
Definitely. We enjoyed playing games and chatting together. They are very friendly and nice. They introduced real Singapore's culture and their school band to us. Their band was much larger than ours. I'm still keeping contact with the friends we met there.
Same for me. I was amazed by the gorgeous campus and the history of their schools. And everyone knows that our school have 90 years of history, and we are all very proud of it. But St. Margaret's, they have been settled for 174 years, and that really shocks me.
Also, they have their own enormous band room for practicing. Before we step into that room, we are asked to take off our shoes. It is an interesting idea, though we didn't get used to do it. The space is so clean and tidy, we immediately understand how much they respect and cherish their own band room.
We also joined an outreach performance at Sentosa, which is a popular island resort in Singapore. And it is a very precious opportunity for us to perform in other countries. And we treasure these kind of chances. See how excited our conductor is. And we enjoy this performance a lot too.
We have also went to see a gala concert in the Esplanade Concert Hall. This is the photo of the appearance of the concert hall. See, just like a durian. Haha. The concert hall at the concert is performed by the symphonic band, which formed by alumni of a university in Thailand. They perform wide range of repertories, including classical music and even Taiwanese pop song for May Day. I'm also impressed by the monkey dance accompanying their performance. It was really interesting. The whole performance is marvelous.
And now let's move on to our sightseeing. We looked around the Newater Visitors Center, where we understand more about the water resources management in Singapore and how to maintain the water supply in a sustainable way through advanced technologies.
We have gone to the landmark of Singapore, the Merlion Park. There are two statues of Merlion with different size. At the same time, we were joining the guided tour around the city. This let me learn more from Singapore. From the tour guide, we know about the history of Singapore and also the Merlion.
This is Gardens by the Bay. It covers over 100 hectares of reclaimed land in central Singapore, and the plants there are very beautiful. And Singapore is a green city. The plants and flowers are planted everywhere. And I was wondering, if Hong Kong were like this, the air would be much fresher.
By the way, we have visited the Little India. It is the place consists of 10 main cultural elements. Sophia, did you try the henna before? Henna there?
Of course, that's beautiful. It can be painted on your hands and it will keep for about 2 weeks. And talking about Little India, I thought of the Chinatown.
It is featuring Chinese cultural elements. It gave me a feeling that I was in Hong Kong.
Me too. Hey, Kiss, which part of sightseeing do you like most?
That day to the Universal Studio. We had great fun there. Playing rides in amusement parks is my favorite. For example, the roller coaster Battlestar Galactica is reached 90 km per hour in its high speed. The 90-second ride is dizzying. At certain points frightening, but complete exhilarating. It was a great ride experience for me.
Haha, I'm not as energetic as you, but undeniably, Universal Studio is a very exciting place. And other than that, we visited Marina Barrage. And here we can learn about the method of turning seawater into drinking water. And we also visited the largest bookstore in Singapore, and it sells books of a very wide range of genres.
We are not going to talk about every place we have visited, or else it will take us an hour. This tour to Singapore is really fantastic and broadens my horizon. Joining band competition in other countries is a new experience to me. Adapting to a new environment is not easy, but I've managed to do this. I learned to play trombone from Form 1. Just 2 years' time, I can't even imagine I can join the band. To me, this is a good opportunity in enhancing my skills and be more capable. 6 days seems to be long, but actually short. I will miss this tour to Singapore.
This is our band family. Having a symphonic band in a school is not that easy. And here I got a group of bandmates, and it should be friends, yeah. And band is the place where maintains our friendship. And not only friends, but we're in a family, and we're better together. And here I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our band members, because all of you are trying your best to contribute to our band. And our conductor, he takes a lot of time to conduct our band and improve our standards. And also our music teacher, Mr. Leung, who puts a lot of efforts in planning this tour. Without you all, we're nothing. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Form 5 24
喂，好啦，出嚟啦，出嚟啦，又到分享嘅时间啦，我哋唔系今晚又冇得瞓啊。咁其实我哋嚟紧会做啲乜嘢咧？其实我哋每一晚完咗我哋嘅 program 之后咧，我哋都会进行一个夜晚嘅 sharing。咁我哋会喺个细细嘅房里面啦，一齐去倾下。咁我哋今日咧都会请到我哋随团嘅我哋嘅资深领队 Bibian， 我哋俾啲掌声我哋 Bibian 吓。咁佢系嚟自我哋青少年海外交流中心嘅。咁佢其实我哋成个团六日五夜啦。咁其实 Bibian 咧就每一日咧都会同我哋进行呢个 sharing。咁我哋今日咧就都会邀请到佢嚟到我哋当中，系啦。好 ，thank you。Bibian 啊，你記唔記得咧？我哋第一晚 sharing 問過一個問題，記唔記得我哋問乜嘢咧？
你突然間咁樣考我，
係啦。不如我哋再次問翻佢一個問題，你哋可唔可以話俾我？你哋有冇邊個可以話到俾我哋知道咧？當初你點解會報呢個團咧？有冇人話到俾我知啊？或者俾我見到阿朱仲成啊，朱仲成可唔可以同我哋講下？
咁啊，梗係為咗玩啦、啊！除此之外咧，就係、是、可以服務其他人啦、啊。即係我想體驗一下咧，人哋話即係服務人都可以拎到啲嘢，咁我想試一下係點樣咯、
啊。可唔可以再講多少少？嗱，我哋當中我哋進行咗兩個 service program 啦，一個就去福利院啦，去幫一啲小朋友啦，另外亦都去到一間小學嘅。你可唔可以話到俾我知道你攞到啲咩走啊？
愛
啊！可唔可以具體少少你嘅愛係點咧？
有一次咧，就要接飛機嗰啲咁嘅嘢啊，跟住咁我啊話要攞張紙咁樣，跟住咧派嗰個人咧就唔俾我啊，跟住咧，跟住隔離個細路竟然話：，我俾你啊咁樣講，跟住本身得人一人一張咁樣，跟住佢都肯俾我，跟住即係可以睇得出佢，即係我去到唔係淨係。服務佢係同佢一齊玩咁樣
咯。我哋俾掌聲朱仲成好唔好啊？好。Bibian 啊，你有冇嘢問佢哋啊？
啊，其實咧，你哋係有冇之前去過廟寨？我哋喺嗰度住過一晚。有冇去過之前？冇。咁其實你去到嘅時候，同香港嘅環境係咪好唔同啊？好唔同。咁其實你去到嗰個感覺同香港個唔同咧，同你經過住咗一晚之後，你嗰個感覺有冇同第一次睇同離開呢個寨嘅時候，你個感覺會唔會有啲唔同？你可以同我哋講到分享一下。
有冇人可以同我哋分享一下？因為我記得你哋好似嗰晚好多人都冇瞓啊嘛，因為嗰個環境，可唔可以分享一下你哋當中嘅感受啊？
好啦，其實。冇，即係我覺得即係可能啱入隊嗰陣，覺得哇點解個環境咁差？因為佢上面個網咧積咗好多塵，即係我嗰個牀嗰個位咧，引住同埋嗰啲電，即係嗰啲插頭嗰啲咧，都好似好危險咁樣。即係我覺得有啲驚，跟住住完一晚之後，其實覺得都冇乜嘢，即係同平時喺香港瞓覺就差唔多，我覺得
我好記得林遠冰有一幕咧，就係因為我哋當中會做三個 service 嘅苗寨，即係三個體驗啦，就會去喂豬啦，去摘菜啦，同埋去拉尾去泥田捉魚啦。咁佢係第一個話：，我自己舉手，我願意去喂豬嘅一個人。咁我覺得俾啲掌聲林遠冰，佢嘅作大膽嘗試好唔好？咁但係係啦，咁林遠冰就覺得咦嗰、那個體驗佢都克服得到。有冇人係嗰晚係冇瞓到㗎？有冇邊個係冇瞓到㗎嗰晚？舉手好嘛？冇嗰晚係瞓唔到嘅不如我問下張英婷啊，張英婷，你可唔可以同我哋分享一下你對嗰個環境又會帶到啲咩感受俾你咧？
好熱咯，想翻屋企咯，想走咯，同埋好大陣尿味咯，放到唔知道，因為我哋十幾個人即係逼埋曬一齊啦，跟住得兩部風扇啊，跟住即係。我哋係即係好焗好熱啦，但係即係玩玩下，後屘都覺得冇乜嘢。但係洗完個頭係一路都乾唔到咯，跟住好辛苦咯，我哋。
但係你諗翻咧，你同之後我哋都住翻酒店噶嘛？咁其實你 compare 兩個 experience， 其實喺苗寨嗰個有冇啲雖然環境差，但係特別好嘅會帶到俾你，即係可能喺酒店係冇嘅。
啲風景好靚。冇啦。
咁我又想問一下，如果假設再俾你去多一次貴州嘅話， 你覺得苗寨嗰晚嘅體驗，你會唔會想誒、想？你會唔會覺得係值得，或者你覺得都可以試一下而攞到嘢走嘅咧？
我覺得都可以試一下嘅，因為即係就算夜晚係好辛苦、好熱啦，但係朝頭早即係望出去會覺得好舒服咯，個風景同埋始終即係郊區同社區都唔一樣，香港係冇機會見到呢啲風景。
最重要就是因為有時候我們在香港裏面沒有見過的東西，我們就希望透過這個交流團去體驗，我們都給他們掌聲，因為去作出這個嘗試去體驗。好了，另外呢，我覺得苗寨有一樣東西，就是我們很多人都沒有想過會做，我自己都沒有想過，就是去落泥田捉魚。有誰是落了泥田的？好了，我試試問一下何怡靜，你落泥田那一刻你又有什麼感受呢？
其實我那時候是想我究竟落不落，因為本身我 expect 自己是一個小溪或者一個池塘捉魚，但沒有想過在那個田裡有那些不知什麼昆蟲、不知名的植物，即是我問老師，那些老師都不知道咯即是我後來在想我究竟落不落去，因為那些泥真的很骯髒，但我後來都想一下，即係人生可能你就得呢一次機會咧，不如試下豁出去啦。咁你人生寧願後悔過你一做咗啲嘢都唔好，即係總之你唔好後悔啦，係咯。所以我都係同 Tammy 一齊落去試下咯。
我俾掌聲佢哋好嘛？咁我哋又去試下去翻去到小學啦。我哋苗寨行完一次咁樣啦，我哋去翻小學，去翻福利院。福利院的時候咧，邊一個係負責去組organize 嗰個嘅 program 㗎？可唔可以嗰兩位同學嘅舉手啊？係啦，我想問咧，因為我哋一去到嘅時候咧，都有啲突發嘅事件，我哋冇估到原來當中有一啲係可能係溝通能力比較弱嘅朋友啦，或者係智力比較弱嘅朋友啦。當其時你去到嗰個環境，你哋有啲咩應對，或者你又學到啲乜嘢咧？阿羅康庭啊，好嘛？
佢哋即係之前一開始係同佢哋溝通唔到啦，咁但係之後開始玩咗好多遊戲之後就佢哋都同我哋融合為一體啦，即係佢哋都佢哋都唔怕醜啦，同埋佢哋都玩得好開心啦。咁即係我當初原本係 organize 個section 嘅，但係之後我就怕醜啦，咁我就唔敢同啲小朋友一齊玩，即係唔敢做 MC 啦。咁但係之後我都好好開心。
其實記得就係初頭，即、就、係、是、好似初頭係會有啲混亂，大家都唔係好投入。但係到咗後屘係大家都好融入咗個氣氛喺入邊。咁但係我點聽我都想問一下，例如頭先講福利院就可能有溝通嗰個問題啦。咁喺小學嘅時候，又有冇啲你哋 unexpected 嘅 challenge 出現咗，而你哋點樣去解決嗰一樣嘢？有冇同學有呢方面嘅睇法？小學有冇遇過啲咩完全冇預計到嘅難處出現咗？
在小學嗰時，一開始叫你集合玩遊戲嘅時候咧，跟住有幾個細路仔就唔肯出嚟啦。跟住我就話：一齊出嚟玩啦！跟住個細路仔同我講話：有冇錢㗎？出嚟玩遊戲。跟住之後，我唔知點樣應付咯。跟住我同我賴遠林一齊去，之後成功叫咗嗰幾個男仔一齊出嚟玩，跟住最後都玩得好開心。
唔知道大家會覺得原來參加一個旅行參加一個交流團咧，有冇啲特別嘅條件咧？係咪要讀書好至可以參加，或者覺得讀書自己本身好叻嘅時候就唔需要參加呢啲團隊？其實我哋當中我哋呢一度嘅朋友咧，其實我諗有一啲係讀書好叻嘅，有啲係搞活動好叻嘅。我都想睇下知道，如果假設我本身係讀書叻嘅時候，又有冇啲嘢可以覺得喺個團裏面攞得走嘅咧？我不如揾阿郭若楠去同我哋分享一下好唔好啊？
咁其實我算唔算好好咧？認真，但係我覺得
參加個交流團啦，本身你學到嘢同你讀書本身好定唔好係冇關係嘅，因為交流你睇嘅係完全另外一樣嘢啦。好多時候我哋可能呢個階段都係講緊好著重成績，好講緊學業啦，好多嘢好多時候比較第一樣嘢都係呢個啦。但係我覺得當你去交流嘅時候，你係完全放低曬呢啲嘢啦，係完全去接觸一個全新嘅領域咯，就係點樣去同人哋接觸啊，點樣去搞一個活動啊，點樣去帶領人哋啊，尤其是同一啲比你細嘅細路仔一齊去玩，我覺得呢啲都係好難得嘅體驗咯。
好啦，因為都時間差唔多，我想問多最後一條問題。我哋成日都覺得呢個唔係一個六日五夜嘅團，呢個係一個我哋人生裡面嘅一個學習嘅課程。咁我想問你哋覺得喺呢個團裡面，你覺得可以改變到你生命？哪怕一點兒都好啦，咁可唔可以舉一舉手俾我哋睇下？點解呢個團可以帶到你嘅人生有啲嘅改變嘅？有冇？好啦，咁不如我試下問一下阿唐善晴啊，可唔可以同我哋講下？依去到中六啦，依你去參加咗呢個團啦，對你嘅人生有啲咩改變咧？
經過呢個團之後，我會更加珍惜同啲人一齊嘅時間咯。同埋珍惜自己有嘅嘢，因為嗰度苗寨啲小朋友其實冇我哋咁幸福，所以係咯。
好我諗永遠我哋呢，有時我哋搞團都好啦，我哋發覺有時我哋以為係特別係 service tour， 我哋以為 serve 好多，我哋帶到好多俾當地嘅小朋友，但係拉尾原來發覺我哋攞嘅嘢可能更加多。我哋唔係我哋希望大家再次俾掌聲呢24位嘅同學，唔係因為佢哋俾咗好多，而係因為佢哋放膽去試，去攞到好多嘢走。咁我哋今日嘅 sharing 去到呢一度，我將個時間交翻俾我哋嘅 MC。
This is the end of all the sharing today. We hope that you've enjoyed it and will be keen to join the study tours that will be announced in this coming year. As a highlight of the tours, a 9-day leadership training tour to Silk Road will be organized. The application details will be announced later. This is the end of today's sharing. Now may I pass the mic to Mr. Mok.